Hey everybody, Mike here. Welcome to the third part of my three-part camera basics mini-series where we're covering the topics of aperture, shutter speed, and ISO. And guys, in today's video, we're gonna be covering ISO. Now before we jump into this today, guys, I do just wanna mention that if you haven't checked out the first two parts of this series where I covered aperture and shutter speed, the links to both of those will be down in the description of this video so you can check those out. And I also have a handy dandy playlist that you can watch as well where you can watch all these videos in order. And it'll get you caught up to speed nice and easy. Okay, so the topic of ISO is actually rather easy to explain, but we're gonna start with the basic question here of what is ISO? ISO in digital photography measures the sensitivity of the image sensor inside of a camera. Some people like myself pronounce it ISO, other people pronounce it ISO. It doesn't really matter. We're both talking about the same thing and you can say it however you want. Okay, so a super easy way to think about and understand ISO is to just think of it as artificial light. So the higher you set your ISO number, the more you're increasing your camera's sensitivity to light. And what this is gonna do, it's gonna brighten up your image and make it brighter, but this comes at a cost. When you increase the ISO, you're actually going to be also increasing the noise or the grain in that image. So this is usually seen in images as dots or pixelated chunks. Generally, it's just worse quality. Some of the drawbacks of using a high ISO are going to be things like trichromatic aberrations. You're also going to get reduced dynamic range in your images, and you're also going to get reduced color accuracy. So generally speaking, the better your camera, the better ISO performance you're going to get. And usually this is going to be seen in situations with lower light. So with a better camera, you'll be able to use higher ISO values without the image getting too grainy. And just so you know, from a consumer perspective, the larger the camera's image sensor is, like the actual physical size of that sensor, the better that camera will perform in low light situations. Okay, so how is ISO shown? This is typically represented on a camera using a value like 200, 400, 1600, something like that. So online, I found out that the normal range of ISO goes from about 200 to 1600, but some of today's digital cameras have technology in them that allow them to go as low as 50 and as high as over 400,000. My camera, for example, has an ISO range that starts at 100 and it goes all the way up to 16,000 and then is expandable to 25,600. Okay, so let's quickly talk about how ISO is used and how it relates to photography and videography. Higher ISOs are typically used in scenes with lower amounts of ambient light. So this would be stuff like if you're shooting photos indoors or if you're outside at night trying to take pictures of the stars, stuff like that. Scenes that just generally don't have a lot of light are usually going to lend themselves to you increasing the ISO on your camera. Higher ISO values are also used in situations where you might be shooting wildlife or sports photography, so you need a really, really fast shutter speed in order to freeze the action and the motion that you're trying to capture in that image. And maybe your shutter speed needs to be so fast so that you can freeze that image, but at the same time, because the shutter speed is so fast, you're not letting in enough light, that's where you would bump up your ISO. So some people who shoot wildlife photography or sports photography will actually shoot at a higher ISO, which will then allow them to use a faster shutter speed. Okay, so here's some advice I wanna give you guys about ISO. Always try and use the lowest possible ISO value that you can in the given scenario and situation that you're in. So as I mentioned earlier, increasing the ISO value on your camera will actually decrease the image quality or the video quality that you're capturing. And so it's smart to try and use the lowest possible ISO value that you can in the given situation that you're in, so that you're actually maximizing the image quality that's coming out of your camera. So ISO is going to affect videos the same as it does with photos. The more you increase the ISO, the lower your video quality is going to be. All right guys, so that's gonna do it for today. I sincerely hope that you guys learned something from this video. Also, I hope that this series was informative to you, whether you're a new photographer, a new filmmaker, maybe you're someone who's experienced and you're just wanting to go back and brush up on the basics. Either way, I sincerely hope that you guys learned something and enjoyed this series. I'm probably gonna do a separate video coming up where I'm gonna be merging all three of these topics, both with aperture, shutter speed, and ISO, where we're just gonna be talking about exposure and how those three relate to exposure. But if you've been following thus far throughout this series, you might already have an understanding about how aperture, shutter speed, and ISO now all go into creating a properly exposed image, whether that be a photograph or a video or whatever. I also just wanna say that if you haven't seen the previous two episodes of this series, you can check those out down in the description below. There's gonna be links to both of those, as well as the playlist covering all of my camera basics videos. And moving forward, guys, I am gonna be doing more videos like this. I am really, really enjoying doing this kind of thing and teaching you guys some stuff and sharing some of my knowledge with you. So guys, make sure you hit that subscribe button and also click the bell icon as well. That'll give you notifications so that every time I upload a new video, you'll get notified. And you know, that's like the best thing to do nowadays anyways, because look, let's face it, YouTube does a really bad job of making sure videos get distributed to everybody who subscribes. So if you click that bell, it will make sure that you get notified of future uploads. And speaking of future uploads, I have some new travel vlogs coming up very soon that I am super pumped and excited about. Cannot wait to show those to you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.